Yeah, we are back here at the live Demexco Talk 2011 at the booth of TV One and Demexco, and we have the next guest. Very interesting. It's Alfredo Congatena. He is the CMO, the Chief Marketing Officer of MasterCard Worldwide. So first of all, we'd like to talk about the term we have defined our small interview. It's about brand building in the digital age. Please define the term brand building from the perspective of MasterCard.
Well, it's a complete revolution. Today, if you wish, the brands that used to be on a pedestal into an ivory tower, created by advertising agencies, created by marketing people, is now literally like in the hands of the consumers, not just one, not just 10, billions.
So you lost control?
I think that the whole idea is that you need to have much greater control now that it is in the hands of these people. MasterCard is one of the largest networks, as you know, worldwide. We have 1.7 billion cards around the world. That is one human being out of three. It's enormous. That means we are reaching an incredible amount of households as the means of payments. So if you define your brand as an esoteric conceptual brand, as opposed to understanding that today that brand is in the hands and in the wallets of over a billion people, you don't understand. So you have to make sure that whatever the brand says and communicates or means to people is real. It's not fiction. It is not a laboratory. It is not an advertising claim. It is the reality. And that is the major change I think we're seeing, which is a challenge, but at the same time is a huge opportunity for brands that are really useful around the world.
Are there some rumors that you're going to launch something new in about 2 weeks? Can you tell us what it is?
Well, it's not just a rumor, it's the reality.
Again?
We're in the world of reality, yes. We have announced that this little card that you have seen and loved for something like 40 years now, is actually on the way to disappear.
Okay,
and
but
what it
not
means,
the service around it, right?
Correct, which means that it's going to become virtual. It will actually show up on your mobile phone.
Okay.
So we just announced that in partnership with Google, Citibank and Sprint, which is in the US one of the telco carriers, we will have, for the first time, a virtual card in the mobile phone to execute payments. So you have to imagine a complete revolution coming up whereby your wallet will disappear and it will be replaced literally by your mobile phone.
This is not something very new. I think in South Korea, it's the
yes.
way to pay for roughly 8 to 10 years.
It is true, and it's not 100% new in the United States either. Here, for example, I have a very minute card, you can see it, a MasterCard card, which allows you to literally pay by just touching the terminal. You don't need to sign, you don't need to put a PIN code. This is directly an antenna transmits your payment to the machine. But the revolution versus what we have seen in Korea or in Africa is actually that this little guy is going inside the phone. It's going to become part of the phone, of the software, and not physical anymore.
Okay. Do I need special phones for that? Or is
yes.
It... Okay.
Yes. Clearly, this is going to be available in the smartphones.
Okay.
So the first one is of course, the Android phone of Google.
Mm-hmm.
But I suspect that over time it will be available on any smartphone around the world.
Mm-hmm. Is it something to do with the near-field communication
Correct.
System?
Okay. Yes.
Because there's some, again, rumors that the new iPhone of Apple might have that, or maybe they choose another way to do it. That's something which is not clear right now.
We do not know at the moment exactly what the future of the technology is going to be, whether it's only pure NFC or another system. What I can assure you is that MasterCard will be in the center. And for a very simple reason. You have 1.7 billion people, 24,000 banks, 30 million merchants, somebody has to connect them.
Of course.
And the systems today that have been built by a network like MasterCard, which is basically making transactions in milliseconds, is going to be at the heart of the payment industry, no matter which form it takes.
Just to give us a number, how much money you transfer per day to get an
something,
impression?
Well, not in terms of money, but we execute per day something around 23 billion transactions, and that goes from Kenya all the way to San Francisco in a way that people don't even think of. Just like our grandparents when they heard the first telephone call. Now you can be literally somewhere in Nairobi. You love to buy a carpet in Nairobi, you can do it. And the money will come out of your bank account in Köln in a few seconds.
Okay, so you're really supporting the idea of the global village. It's a one time, or not only many time used word term, the global village, everything goes together, comes closer.
But
and payment is a very important thing.
There is something quite extraordinary. The more the planet is becoming global, the more what matters to you is actually where you live. It's a paradox. Because 80% of what you purchase is in 14 minutes around your home.
14
minutes.
Okay, which is very close.
So, which means that today you're no longer from Germany. You are from Köln. You are from Munich. Ich bin ein Berliner. That is more important. So, MasterCard has understood this new trend that people from Milan are not very much fans of Rome. People from Barcelona don't really like Madrid. They like Barcelona. That's why the Barca is their local team. So we are launching what we have now baptized priceless cities, which means we're bringing the cities back to the people that have chosen to live in that city, and the ability to rediscover the emotions, what is secret, what is so beautiful that the city has prepared for you and you were not even aware.
How do you make them, let's say, how do you make that happen? What is the benefit for the customer?
I give you a few examples. We just launched this in New York 6 weeks ago on July 11th. And what we understood is that experiences for people matter more than physical things. So, for example, in New York, 6 million people, 4 million of them go to see the New York Yankees baseball game. 4 million out of 6. And when they are there, they are not New Yorkers anymore. They are fans of the Yankees. They all wear stripes, the famous hat.
Yeah.
And what we did then is to create experiences money cannot buy. For example, you would come a half an hour before the game. You will go to the pitch. You're going to swing together with the professionals, even if you have no clue on how to do it. You will go with your son, because the Americans have this tradition to transmit the sport from generation to the next. And suddenly, we create an environment where finally the father can have a conversation with their son, something that at home never happens. So we're trying to understand the fabric of the New Yorkers, what is important to them, why did they choose to live in that city, which is crazy, but at the same time being able to enjoy it in a way that money cannot buy. That's why we call it priceless.
Okay. From now up to, let's say, the next 3 years, where are you going to see your brand in this future, in this near future?
My sense is that the new markets, whether India or China, Brazil, Russia, the so-called BRIC, is literally going to take over from what we have known for 50 years or so, which is Western Europe and the US. We see already that our second largest market in the world, MasterCard, is Brazil, second largest. So the next frontier is definitely what we would call the next billion people, because in this world, only one third of human beings have a bank account. Only one third. yet two-thirds have a mobile phone. So the revolution for Kenya, for Nigeria, for what we would call sub-Sahara Africa, and it's the economic development, is going to be through the facilitation of payments. Very simply stated, imagine a businessman in Kenya. He has decided to open a shop in his village. He has to buy things from the closest town. The closest town could be 25 kilometers away. There are no buses, there are no taxis. He needs to literally walk all the way to bring the cash to that place, buy the things, and walk again 25K.
He can save one way, right?
Two ways.
He gets the, let's say...
By simply paying through the mobile phone. And that is happening today. You have over 100 telecommunication carriers in Africa operating already mobile payments. So what we would say in the old model, where the West would lead the way, we are being surprised. It's not true. It is the world of the digital world. And that means that the inventions that facilitate daily lives of people in Africa or in China or in India is actually who is going to create the discontinuity and therefore the innovation.
Okay. Very interesting.
Cool.
Thank you.
Thank you for stopping by.
Thank you.
That was Mr. Gangotena. He is the CMO of MasterCard Worldwide. Very interesting topic, brand building in the digital age. And we will see you next year at our booth at the Live in Mexico Talk 2011. Thank you for watching.
Danke.
Vielen Dank.
Vielen Dank.